For a town its size, Ukiah has lots of really good arts organizations. But 2 years ago, when the Ukiah Daily Journal published its end-of-the-year wrap-up, there was not one mention of any art event. There were sports, murders, movie reviews, but not one mention of the arts.
Not long after, we took responsibility to create a strategic plan for our organizations, Ukiah Players Theater and SPACE, the School of Performing Arts and Cultural Education. We gathered around the table, eating our sack lunches with the city manager, vice president of the bank, and publicity director of the Mendocino College, and talked about how just like we grow pears and grapes and timber products, Ukiah grows the arts. Though we'd been doing the work for a long time, it was our job to make sure people knew it. In 1977, I was a founding member of Ukiah Players, a community theater in our little Northern California town. Since then, we've produced hundreds of plays at the Ukiah Playhouse, the theater we built in 1982. We've worked mostly with adults, focusing more and more on the community's history and stories with the intent of illuminating, healing, and transforming.
Laurel Neer and I founded SPACE in 1995. It grew out of Performing Arts Summer Camp that was a collaboration with Kate at the Playhouse. 65 young people, ages 8 to 15, spent a month learning to act, sing, dance, make visual art. We wrote the plays ourselves because no such thing existed for a cast that size, and because we wanted the material to address issues of diversity, inclusion, the environment, and sustainability. But really, the theme was always about how to get along and be a good person. Laurel said it well.
Inclusion strategies, what are those? Those are ways that we can learn about ourselves and others to make friendships across age, across gender, across cultural barriers, across our history. And if we can develop that as well as develop teachers, we can provide an area, a space for art to be everywhere.
We realized that together, SPACE and UPT could provide arts experiences for people throughout their entire lives. Everybody's got a story. More and more, our programs offer ways for people to share those stories with each other, uncovering the past as well as exploring our contemporary lives. This act of telling and listening forms bonds. It weaves us together, nourishes us. In the most fundamental way, it builds community.
Because it's, you know, art is like food. Everyone, it shouldn't be a privilege. It really should be a right that we get to eat and we get shelter and we have art. Art, you know, every day I see how art saves lives of children, of the parents that come and are involved. It just helps. I'm a real parent advocate that we parents need a lot of support. And if we can get that support through the arts for our children, it changes our life.
And as much as art feeds our spirits, it literally puts food on the tables. We employ people, we buy materials and equipment. We're renovating an historic building into a downtown performing arts center for children and families. In Ukiah, in addition to agriculture, we're cultivating arts and education programs, working together with government and business to create a community where young people can earn a living.
The future dream would be how we all become really sensitized and vigilant to make sure that the Playhouse, that Space Theater, that these institutions really celebrate all the diverse groups, communities, ages, because it will only make everything that much richer and more exciting to learn about each other and to know ourselves and to know others. And it's hard to keep that in mind. It slips off really quickly unless all of us pay attention to make sure that groups get access to the resources and to the building and to the funding that supports everybody's art.
Ukiah grows the arts. It's a concept that will guide us in developing a healthy, sustainable, inclusive community that can serve as a model and a magnet. Ukiah grows the arts. A truly renewable resource.